welcome to the Game Case. Today on the collection, we have a two-parter. We are going to do my top rarest NES games, but divided into two categories. The first one is going to be loose carts. The second one is going to be complete in box. So today we're going to tackle the first one, which is loose carts. So for loose carts, I actually kind of did these to where the first three I'm going to go through are actually like two games. Cass, get out of there. Cass, stop it. Cass, stop. All right. Restart. Hello everyone, welcome to the Game Case. My name is Jerry, and today we've got a new episode of the collection. This is actually going to be part one. There will be a part two. So basically it's, what are the rarest, most expensive, uncommon NES games I own? This first video is actually going to be loose carts. The second video that will come later will be complete in box, or at least in box. There are a few games in there that I need the manual for, but whatever. So, let's start with loose carts. So, for this, the first three I'm going to do are actually going to be two games a piece. So, what's going to, the first one's going to be Mega Man 5 and Gargoyle's Quest. That's Mega Man 5, that's Gargoyle's Quest. So, the reason they're both here is because, well, Mega Man 5 is the rarest Mega Man game for the NES, and that's the one that people seem to have the most problems getting. So it's really shot up in price, so I figured I'd show it. Gargoyle's Quest 2 is another Capcom one that's also worth a decent amount of money if you can find it. So I just wanted to show Gargoyle's Quest and Mega Man 5. Next we're going to go into Dragon Warrior 3 and Dragon Warrior 4. They both go for pretty much, I'm dying, the same amount of money, and they're both really, really good. This is where you start really getting it. Dragon Warrior 4 especially is where you start really getting into, like, what makes the Dragon Quest games. So, I want to show those. The next two are Koei games. I will be eventually doing a video on all my Koei games, but they're going to pop up in videos all the time just because I have so many of them and they fit so many categories. So, Le Emperor and Bandit Kings of Ancient China. I got Le Emperor in a trade, and I got Bandit Kings of Ancient China from my grandfather who lives in Dothan, Alabama. And on the back, you can see this used to belong to a place in Daleville, Alabama. Video Game Exchange. Do y'all remember when video game stores would put, like, the stickers like that on the back so that people could find them? Like, it is really smart because, it has a phone number on it and everything. I have no idea if the phone number works. Probably not. But you could, you know, you had games like that. So if someone ended up buying them and then taking them to a flea market and someone bought, you know, Bandit Kings of Ancient China and they saw that number, they could call and see if there's someone there. And for us collectors, it's kind of cool because maybe you'll find a game from a store you used to go to, and there's a clear marking of how to do, of where it's at. Okay. So, let's go into my top five. You know, I didn't check prices before this, so I don't know if any of the previous games I just showed are actually more expensive or rarer now than these, but these just work really well in pairs. So we'll start with DuckTales 2 for the NES. I still need the Chip 'n Dale Rescue Rangers number 2, but it seems a lot of the later Capcom games really went up in price. Gargoyle's Quest 2, DuckTales 2, Mega Man 5, Chip 'n Dale number 2. There's another Mighty Final Fight. I don't have that one. I have it for the Famicom, though, so I usually just play it on there. Plus, I've got a Game Boy Advance game that has it on there. It's like, Capcom Classic Minimix or something like that. Anyway, the next one, Contra Force. This one I got from my fiance. She gave it to me as a birthday or Christmas present. I think it was a Christmas present, if I remember correctly. I did a video a little bit back about games she had gotten me as a response video to someone. So Contra Force, and cool story, I do have the manual for this because John Blurix actually sent it to me for free. Because he's the man. Another one that was a gift from Reese, Godzilla 2 for the NES. And even though I don't like playing this game, I love the artwork. I really, really want a box for it. One day I will. It's just, I'm probably going to end up having to buy a complete unbox and then selling my extra cart. Is what I'm eventually going to have to do. Because it's so hard to get just a box and manual. Plus, you're going to pay a premium if you're buying box and manual compared to buying a complete box and then just selling the double. Anyway, okay. So, this next one is really important to me because it did something that I had wanted to complete for a while, which was complete my NES Koei collection. And this was the last one I needed to get. Nobunaga's Ambition 2. A buddy of mine was selling his pretty much entire game collection on Instagram, and I bought a bunch of games from him, including this one. This was the biggest one I bought from him. I was really excited about it. It completed my Koei collection, which obviously, if you haven't noticed by the three Koei games I showed in this video, I love Koei. So, the rarest game I own, Loose Cart, is... It's in a pack. It's in a protective sleeve. Because it's that rare. So I'm going to take it out of the plastic sleeve real quick. Is Little Samson, which also, by the way, has a sticker on the back that says Game Time Inc. Instant Cash for Used Games and CDs. And they have a 1-800 number right there. But Little Samson. So the story behind this is, my grandfather, who gave me a lot of my collection, has always helped me with my collection, is the start of my collection and why I collect retro video games. He found this at a garage sale 5-6 years ago, back when this was $150 for cart only. And he found it, and he wasn't going to buy it because they wanted $5 for it, and he had a rule where he didn't like to pay more than like $2.53 per game. But for some reason, he ended up doing it, and he did buy it, and I'm so glad he did because he gave it to me. And I was so excited because at the time, this was $150. That was super expensive for a game, and it was something that I would probably never have, so I was really glad to get it. And it's in really good condition. It has one nick. I don't know if you can see it right. You might not be able to see that. But it has one nick at the top, and that's it. Other than that, it is in great condition. So I got this for free after my grandfather paid $5 for it at a garage sale when it was going for $150, and now it's shooting over $900 for just a cart, which sometimes now you know why, like, saying $900 for something I got for free makes you think about selling the collection, which is another video I just did that did really well, and you guys really liked it. So, those are my rarest loose NES games. Coming up soon will be my rarest complete in-box games. So, look forward to seeing that. Like, subscribe, comment, tell me what your rarest loose games are. Tell me what your favorite rare loose games of mine that you want, need, whatever. Let me know. Tell me your story behind the rarest grab you got. And I will see you next time here on The Game Case.